Got original 1960 F100 radio truck. This is the original radio, and we've gone completely through it, redone all the paint on the dial, polished it up, polished the outer knobs. I don't know if you've got a set of them or not. New chrome in here because the other one was flaking real bad. Brand new outside knobs and center knob, and we've done a complete case cleanup on it. It now has a AM FM stereo, auxiliary in. It's got four channels out, 45 watts a channel. It's got a pre-out on it if you want to add a sub. The auxiliary in is automatic. All you do is plug in any device that you've got, satellite radio, XM radio, CD changers, iPods, iPhones, anything. Anything that plays music, you can plug it into here and turn it on. It will automatically switch over. Let's see. We've got USB port. This is your auxiliary in here. This is your USB port, which will charge your phone, your devices, and play a thumb drive, which comes with it. We'll also have music on it and this video. It's push button operated, control operated. It has a Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, voice command, voice ID, voice assistance. It's fully loaded. And we're going to demonstrate a little of it today. Right now you're on FM. You got an operating LED right here. It's real small, and a stereo LED. This one changes multiple colors. This one lights up when you find a stereo channel. So if you hook up one speaker, it'll go straight to mono. You won't have a stereo light. You'd be using one speaker. But if you hook up two channels, you'll have a stereo light. You'll have balance built in your toner control. If you hook up three or more, you'll have stereo light, balance, and fader built in your toner control. If you have original toner control, and I'll be demonstrating all of it for you. It will also scan your stations. We'll show you that. If you want to go to AM radio, just simply turn the unit off and right back on. It takes you to AM radio.
How's it holding you, sir? Holding, chair.
I have to give news that people never.
Off and right back on. Takes you right back to FM stereo. Yellow prime day. First thing we're going to do, I'm going to show you how to get it in the scanning mode. It will scan for stations without the needle moving. That way, if you're going down the road, you can put it in that mode. She'll tell you in that mode. And when you find one, I'll show you how to lock on it. I'll show you how to actually even find it on the dial and to how to identify it, because we have an AM dial, you're on FM. First thing you want to do is take your tuning knob and turn it up twice.
Scanning for stations.
Even take that plan anymore.
Now it's going to start scanning without the needle moving.
Told them about Metashare.
With our previous.
For Catholic social justice, Sister Simone, thanks very much for talking.
We're going to let it scan a few stations, and I'm going to show you how to lock on it.
Political reporter for the Washington Post, Karen.
UNC policy book states that, quote, the practice of homosexuality is incompatible with Christian teaching. One of the proposed plans endorsed by the UM.
I'll let it go a couple more.
A measure would add clergy to the list of mandatory reporters of child abuse. The state's House Judiciary Committee in a 9-3 vote sent the bill to the
All right. Thank you.
The good stuff.
The good stuff.
Hard at it, aren't you?
Hard at it, man.
Yeah.
1960. All right. Appreciate it.
All right. We'll see you.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
That was my mailman. Alright, we're still scanning stations. Say we like that station there, all we do is turn it once.
Station hold.
She'll hold the station, but right after that, if you won't find it, it will go quiet until you find that station. There it is. Now we know where it's at. Even though we don't have a preset or a preset, we like to know what station that is. All you do is take your volume knob and turn it up three times.
FM. 93.3.
She'll tell you what station it is. It will do that on AM and FM. That's a pretty cool feature on it. especially if you're out of town, you don't know where the radio stations are, and you don't have to be fumbling with it all the time. A lot of people just find one and listen to it, but this way you can scan it until you find one you like. All right. We're going to do the balance and fader. I have four speakers hooked to it. Treble and bass. Just take it about halfway and crank it. We're going to go into fader. We're going to go clockwise like a 12 to 2 motion. 1, 2.
Fader adjust.
Now I can go from rears to fronts. Fine, let's balance it out. Alright, she'll set it.
Fader set.
Alright, now we're going to go into balance, which is counterclockwise, like a 12 to 10 motion. 1, 2.
Balance adjust.
Right side, left side. Let's balance it out where I like it. Alright, there.
Balance set.
Now we're back. We got our speaker set up. All we got to worry about is treble and bass. Alright, we got that done. That's how you do your balance and treble. I mean your bass, treble, balance, fader. Everything is in your toner control. So once you get your speaker set up, you shouldn't have to fool that no more unless you want to just do some fading. Bring your, if you have rear speakers, bring them up. Alright, we're going to do auxiliary in. We're going to bring this little, we got a little MP3 player. You'll get a male-to-male cord. All you do is just simply plug it in and plug your device in. It'll automatically change over.
Yes! Here comes Amos!
Notice the little light's gone to green. That means auxiliary in. Anytime you want to go back to radio your owner device, all you do is just simply turn that device off. In 20 seconds, if you do not touch the radio, it will automatically switch back for you. But during that 20 seconds, if you don't want that dead air, just turn it off and right back on like you're cycling from AM to FM. It remembers where you were at. We're going to let it automatically switch over, make sure everything's right on it. And there it goes. Switch back over.
Drama empire, and so staged a false hate crime.
That's how your auxiliary in works. Now we're going to let her help us. You're going to do the initial pair up on your phone. So we're going to bring the phone up, make sure we're on Bluetooth. And there are several ways you can do it. You can do it with the push button or with the volume knob. We're going to do it with the push button first. We're going to hold it down until she comes on and helps us out.
Smollett will be in court in Chicago for a bond hearing today.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Advisor Roger Stone
showed up on her phone. All we got to do is tap on it. She'll tell us when it's done.
As Ryan Lucas reports, Stone's appearance.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Judge Amy Berman Jackson. All right,
we got that.
To appear in U.S.
Now, every time you get in your truck and you have your phone with you, after you do the initial pair up, she will find it. We're going to do a test on that. We're going to shut the unit off. We're going to give it just a few seconds, like you were stopping at a store or in a cruise, and you're getting ready to go. When it comes back on, she'll go to radio. She'll come on and say Bluetooth connected.
Stone has pleaded not guilty to obstruction.
Bluetooth connected.
Great. At Thursday's
now
hearing,
we're on the phone.
We'll have to explain why.
Now I normally put mics, media contact, built-in mics, but I didn't want to drill a hole in this one. So this is your mic. It's got plenty of extension. You can run it wherever you want to, and just plug it in where it says mic. And we're going to do a voice command. There's two ways of doing it: volume knob or the button. You hold it down.
Situation, and many abuse survivors are likely to be.
Play music. Now it's going to music on my phone. There we are. Now you can advance your songs by pressing the button once. Twice to back up a repeat. Or you can do it with a tuning knob. Turn it up. It works your phone for you. Back up. Go forward. Now, like I said, you can do it with the button or with this. We're going to put our phone back in pause, but we're going to use the volume knob. We're going to go up twice. Stop music. So it does the same as this. Still holding it down, go up twice on the volume knob. Back to radio.
13-year-olds include homicide, robbery, and gun possession.
That's how your Bluetooth hand-free phone calls, when you get a phone call comes in, you can press the button once to answer the call or take the tuning knob and turn it up one click and answer your call. When you're done, let the phone hang up by itself. It'll go back to doing whatever you're doing. Or if you want to end the call, go down one click, press the button twice to end the call.
Task force agrees, saying, quote, maybe some more emphasis needs to be put on middle school children.
With every heart beating my chest.
Now we're going to do a thumb drive. You're going to get one of these with some music on it and video. And when you plug these in, like I said, a lot of people like hide these, so you can leave this in there because you can operate it all here. Let's put it in. Let's go straight to it. Now if I want to advance, same way as I do it, my phone, press it once, we'll advance your songs. Twice, we'll back up, we'll repeat. Or I can use a tuning knob. Same thing. Back up. Now we went up twice. We can put it in pause with this push button by holding it down 1 second. Put this in pause, going right back to radio. Cycles back around. We can also do it with the volume knob. We went up twice for the Bluetooth. Let's go down twice. Do our volume. Do our. All we gotta do is take it down twice. Right back to the thumb drive. Down twice to put it in pause. Put it in pause, right back to radio. Pretty neat little radio. They do not require 12 volt consistent, no batteries to change, no nothing. So there's a blue wire on it in the harness that's for a power antenna or a telemap to come on remote wire. You do not hook that to the battery. So if you take your battery off, you got to shut off on it, you got to store the truck. When you put 12 volts back to this, it'll go back to doing whatever you're doing. And what I really like about it, let's go to thumb drive. All right, we're back on thumb drive. If I shut this radio off, and I don't care how long it sits. I've had some on the shelf that I've done to show that's been there 3 or 4 years. Whatever I shut it off on, when I plug it back up at a show, it'll go right back to doing. If I've got everything pushed back in it, like Bluetooth connected or this, it will do it. She'll come on and go back to that. Right back to it.
Bluetooth connected.
And Bluetooth. Right back to radio. Put this in pause, going right back to radio. That's your 1960 Ford F100 original truck radio. I appreciate you letting me do it for you.